In this video, we're going to talk about selection sort, implement it, and analyze its time complexity. Without further ado, let's deep dive into it. The main idea of selection sort is finding the smallest item and placing it in its correct position. The algorithm divides the input into two sublists, a sorted sublist and an unsorted one. Initially, the sorted sublist is empty, so the unsorted one contains all elements. Each iteration finds the smallest element in the unsorted sublist, swaps it with the leftmost unsorted element, and moves the sublist boundaries one element to the right. In this iteration, the smallest element in the unsorted sublist is 3, and the first element of that is 4, so it swaps them and moves the boundaries. It continues until no elements remain in the unsorted sublist. Selection sort is famous for its simplicity. It's an in-place sorting algorithm, so it doesn't use extra space for manipulating the input. Let's jump into the code, but before that, please like this video if you think it's useful and consider subscribing to the channel. The implementation is quite simple. We need to iterate all over the array, and in each iteration, find the minimum element of the unsorted sublist and place it at its correct position. We declare a variable to store the index of the smallest item of the unsorted sublist. Initially, we assume the first item is the smallest one and iterate over the sublist. Every time we find a smaller item, we update our variable. Finally, we swap the smallest item with the first item of the unsorted sublist. We can have a slight improvement in this code. To understand that, let's see a quick execution of it. In the first iteration, the whole list is unsorted. Variable I shows the start of the unsorted sublist. We assume the smallest element is the first one and store 0 in min index. As we iterate, we find the item with index 3 is smaller, so we update min index and store 3 in it. In the end, we swap 1 and 2, so 1 is placed in its correct position. We increment I by 1, therefore the new unsorted sublist starts from index 1. We go until the last item. In the last iteration, 6 is the only item in the unsorted section, and it's already at its correct position. Here we can have an improvement in the code. As the last iteration only has a single item, we know it's already sorted, so we can skip it. Finding the minimum of n items requires n-1 comparisons. We define tn as the required numbers of comparisons. The first iteration needs n-1 comparisons, the second iteration requires n-2 comparisons, and the last one requires only one comparison. By solving the equation, we see tn is in an order of n squared. So it's not efficient for large inputs, as the number of required comparisons might be quite massive. Thank you for watching the video. If you find it useful, please like it. In this channel, we talk about some interesting stuff about data structures, algorithms, and programming. If you are interested in these topics, please consider subscribing.